Please subscribe my channel for more updates.
Good afternoon, students. Now we will discuss about Maxwell's inductance capacitance bridge. Okay, in the previous class we have discussed about Maxwell's inductance bridge only. In that bridge we are calculating the unknown value of the inductance in terms of known value of the inductance. Here we have to calculate the unknown value of the inductance in terms of capacitance. This is the total circuit diagram of the Maxwell's inductance bridge. It consists of four arms as in the previous bridge. Here the arm 1 consists of inductance Lx and Rx resistance. We have to measure these values Lx and Rx. For this bridge we have to write the impedance equations individually for each arm. Now we have to write the impedance equation for the arm 1. Z1 is equal to Rx plus j omega Lx. Rx is this and j omega Lx this reactance. Next, and impedance of the arm 2 consists of only resistance. There is no inductance present in this arm, so I am writing Z2 is equal to R2. In the third arm, only presenting resistance. There is no presence of inductance. That's why I am writing Z3 equal to R3. In the fourth arm, we have capacitance in parallel with resistance. Those two are in parallel. Now we have to write the parallel circuit equation. Here Z4 is equal to R4 parallel to 1 by j omega C4. Okay. Already we know X is equal to 1 by omega C. From this equation, we have to write the equation for capacitance. Now solving the parallel equation, R4 into 1 by j omega C4 by R4 plus 1 by j omega C4. From this we get equation Z4 is equal to R4 by 1 plus j omega C4 into R4. Now we get all Z1, Z2, Z3, Z4 equations. Already we know what is the balancing condition. In the bridge balancing condition, we have to write Z1 into Z4 is equal to Z2 into Z3. This is the Z1, this is the Z4, this is the Z3, this is the Z2. In the balancing condition, current through the galvanometer is equal to 0, then it can be acts as a open circuit. Then I1 is equal to I3, I1 is equal to I3 and I2 is equal to I4. Here I2 is equal to I4. I4 flows through this branch, this arm. Okay, this I4 can be divided into two parts, IC and I4, because I4 and R4 are connected in parallel. That's why I4 divided into IC plus IR. I4 is equal to IC plus IR. Okay, this is the input supply voltage. By adjusting these known values, we can get the Lx value. Now substitute the impedance values all into this equation. Z1 is equal to R1 plus j omega Lx, already we get here. And Z4 is equal to R4 by 1 plus j omega C4 by R4. And R2, R3. Now we have to multiply all the equations and we get this Rx into R4. And Rx into j omega Lx R4 into equal to R2 R3. Okay. By solving this, we can get this equation. This equation contains real terms and imaginary terms. Rx and R4 indicates a real term, and here R2 and R3 are the real terms. And this indicates imaginary terms of the equation. Now we have to equate and compare these equations. We have to equate the first real terms and then we have to equate the imaginary terms. By comparing real terms, Rx R4 equal to R2 R3. From here we have to find out the value of Rx. That's why we have to shift the R1 to other side. We can get Rx is equal to R2 R3 by R4. This is the value of the unknown AC resistance which is to be measured. And by comparing the imaginary terms of the above equation, we can get Lx is equal to R2 R3 is equal to C4. Now we have to see the equation and we have to observe the equation. This is the unknown inductance of the bridge in terms of capacitance. That's why we called as Maxwell's inductance capacitance bridge. This is the total impedance equation. In this impedance equation, we consist of real part. The Rx is equal to R2, R3 by R4, plus this is the inductive part and imaginary part, J omega R2, R3, R4. This is the total unknown impedance measured by the Maxwell's inductance capacitance bridge. Now we have to draw the phasor diagrams of the Maxwell's inductance capacitance bridge. Here we have to take I1 as a reference. This is the I1 vector here, okay. Next, here in balancing condition of the bridge, I1 is equal to I3. This I1 is equal to I3. That's why I'm taking I1 is equal to I3. Now we have to add the resistance drop and reactance drop of the arm 1 and we get E1, okay. This is the resistance drop I1 into Rx in phase with I1, because this resistance drop in phase with I1 already we know why, okay. Next, we have to add the inductance, this inductive drop to this resistance drop. That's why I'm adding this vector I1 omega Lx is the inductive drop. By adding those we get E1. This we adding this vector and this vector we get E1. This is the vector E1. Already we know in the balancing condition of the bridge E1 is equal to E2. That's why I'm taking E1 is equal to E2, okay. Next, we have to calculate the E3 and E4 also. Now we have to see the value of the current I2 is equal to I4, okay. I4, this is the I4, okay. I2 is equal to I4. This I2 and I2 is in close
something.
This I2 flows through only resistance. There is no inductive element in the this arm. That's why I am representing I2 in phase with E2. I2 in phase with E2. Already we know I2 is equal to I4. That's why I am writing I2 is equal to I4. Now we have to find out the E3 voltage in arm 3. Okay. E3 is equal to I3 into R3. It has only resistance element. That's why I am writing I am drawing I3 into R3 in phase with I3. This is the vector I3 already we know. I am writing in phase with I3. I3 into R3 is equal to E3. Or if E3 is equal to E4 already know balancing condition of the bridge. That's why I am representing I3 is equal to R I3 into R3 is equal to E3 equal to E4. Okay. Here E4 we'll see the E4. Here C4 and R4 are in parallel condition. In the parallel condition, voltage across each branch is equal same, and voltage across the capacitor is equal to voltage across the resistance. That's why I'm writing voltage across the resistance IR into R4 and voltage across the capacitor IC by omega C4. Okay. If we have to add the E1 and E2, we can get total voltage E. That's why I'm writing E is equal to E1 plus E3. This is the E1, this is the E3. Now we have to add E2 and E4, we can get total voltage E. Okay. This is the vector E1, this is the vector E3. By adding those two vectors, we can get total voltage E. Otherwise, if we have to add E2 and E4, this is the vector E2, this is the vector E4. Okay, E3 is equal to E4. By adding those two vectors, we can get total voltage equation E1 plus E3 or E2 plus E4. Thank you.